Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the eResearch Summer Hackfest. This Hackfest is co-organized by three European Union-funded projects. One is Saigea, the other is Indigo Data Cloud, and the third one is a cost action called ENEL, E-N-E-L.
I'm very glad to welcome you here. I mean, Department of Physics of Catania is always happy to have event like this, and in particular, I'd like to welcome a colleague and friend who come from far away.
So there is a challenge: make African science and scientists more visible. And there is an opportunity to exploit e-infrastructures to do that. That is actually what we want to do. And the vision is to promote open science in Africa to make African science and African scientists more visible. The Saigea project is just about that. We want to leverage on e-infrastructure concepts like science gateways, like data infrastructures, to promote open science in the continent. The Saigea is funded by the European Commission with about 1.4 million euros. We started a little bit more than 1 year ago, so we have 10 months to go till the end of April next year. The project is coordinated by the Brunel University and has key partners, European partners and African partners. And we have the two regional research networks, namely UbuntuNet Alliance on the southeast and Wakran on the southwest. This was done in purpose to have, as partners of the project, organizations that can act as interface towards lots of universities and research institutes all over the continent. As I said, the eResearch Summer Hackfest is an event to where we want to bring science to the web and the web to the science. So the main objective is to integrate scientific use cases, those use cases that you proposed, through a pervasive adoption of web technologies and standards, and make them available to their end users through science gateways, portals, desktop applications, I mean, any kind of high-level interface through which people can run the applications that you will be developing in the next days.
My name is Benjamin Aribisala.
I am Eveline van der Vogt.
I am Antonio Calanducci.
My name is Charles Miruri.
My name is Riccardo Bruno.
My name is Andias Elik.
My name is Stefan Gaia.
I'm Bruce Becker.
Davor Ostojic.
I am Elisa Londero.
I'm Jesus Marco.
My name is Diana Ruigassira.
I'm Luca Martinelli.
My name is David Rusnamozzi.
My name is Alessandro Danka.
Xenia Zaitsva.
My name is Aaron Condrolo.
My name is Michał Owsiak.
My name is Fernando Aguilar.
This is Damas Makweba.
My name is Marika Antonacci.
My name is Konrad Zemek.
My name is Krzysztof.
My name is Denis Moki.
The project I'm working on is about developing an infrastructure for medical image analysis. So I actually call it an intelligent medical image analyzer.
My project is a simple human language technology applications that I'm working on, especially dealing with workflows about that. You know, human languages has always been a very critical, important part of all of us. We might not realize it because we're born and naturally we speak. But when you want to move from one language to the next, then you realize that it's not that easy.
My project basically is called iGrid, and it's part of my PhD studies. I'm a PhD student at the University of Dar es Salaam. And essentially what we are trying to do over there is currently a challenge in Tanzania, especially for rural communities, to get access to energy, electrical power in many areas and also in an affordable way. So essentially what we are trying to do is build a small off-grid power generation using renewable resources like solar power in order to generate power. And we are using technology to make it more intelligent and efficient.
Actually, what I'm doing is putting one application called Weka in the Sense Gateway. So Weka is a data mining application.
Actually involved about technology transfer alliance collaboration platform, whereby we want to develop a platform, the platform which will be helping students from the University of Tanzania based on the researchers from other countries so that they can have knowledge and embed it to our students and hence solve our problems in our country.
With ICT normally is the improving the weather information management in East Africa through ICT tools. Right. And particularly this is the project, and the project itself is sponsoring some students under the level of PhD and the master students. These students, they are working on the tools based on weather research and forecasting, WRF, and which is the selected tools which is going to be used by WIME ICT project aspect. So we are thinking that through this summer Hackfest school, we are expecting to develop the WIME portal, future gateway, right. Basically for WRF.
It's been quite lovely, as I would say. It's been quite wonderful. My use case is halfway through being done. I've done most of the planning, the architecture, and the styling. Thank you very much for this opportunity. And once again, my gratitude and acknowledgement to everyone else who contributed. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Roberto, for this opportunity. I have done some work in my use case. Is quite big. I can rate it into 70%. But also what is encouraging me is that I have learned a lot of technology and I have understand how this technology work. I have understand the architecture behind it. I have understand what I supposed to do to finish my use case.
So I would say that the experience here for me has been first of all very educational and eye-opening. In my use case, which is iGrid, I've been able to learn about a lot of tools. I'm happy to say that from this experience, I've been able to get a chance to work with some of the tools that that are going to be helpful as we progress with our project.
I have to say thank you for being here for these 2 weeks. It was very wonderful. Yeah, because I have learned a lot despite for the time. Up to now, I have worked like 60% of the work have been done. Lastly, I have to say thank you for those people, all people of here. You have been helpful for us.
My experience here was really encouraging. I'm actually impressed that we could do that amount of work in 2 weeks' time. I didn't expect we could accomplish that because we just started working on the use case immediately got here. Yeah, so I'm really encouraged that I could do even greater things and take it next to the next level, and probably do some other more use cases using the tools that I've been taught here.
Me and my colleague have been doing some project on a public health gateway, and yeah, I'm also impressed that we could accomplish such amount of work in such a short period. I'm also very grateful for the SAIGEA team for this opportunity, because personally it was a learning experience for me. And I'm also grateful for the tools that they have developed. The tools are really great.
This is some e-research summer Hackfest for the development of applications based on the future gateways. And particularly for my case, I was dealing with the development of the portal for the WIME ICT. WIME ICT is the project which is basically just improving the weather and research forecasting within East Africa. And actually, the web portal, we're expecting that it will make the link between the students and the industrial, because we have the industrial who are working on the same project, the same research. Once again, thank you very much for visiting this University of Catania, and I hope to meet you again in the future workshop, which will be based in Dar es Salaam, and I'm the host, so thank you very much, you're welcome.
It's been a great pleasure to be a participant at this Summer ACFest. I've seen it as a great opportunity for me to actually learn new technologies that are being developed here in Catania, in Catania University. Roberto has been a great man, you know, he's a great scientist. He has exposed us alongside with other team members, you know, to the things they are developing. The open-mindedness is so much appreciated, you know, by us. There is one great thing, or I should say one unique thing about the ACFest. You know, the ACFest did not just give us the knowledge, but it gave us the platform, you know, to know about the technology and to, you know, put them into practice. So we were trained for 2 days. The third day, we were able to discuss with the experts about our use cases. And then from the fourth day, we started to develop, you know, our use cases. So that was fantastic because the support was there. You know, the experts who trained us were here to give us the support, and Roberto stayed with us all through. So it's been a wonderful experience. The hands-on bit was spot on, and I was impressed. You know, I came to see a way of starting a new project on developing what I call medical image analyzer. And I've already started to do the coding, and I could see that the future is very bright for this project. And we've been able to discuss with Roberto again, alongside with others, on where we go from here. And we could see that the future is very bright for all the projects that came here. We can't wait till September, where we're going to be showcasing some of the outputs of this project. And we know in a larger picture, collaborations will stem out of this, and we're going to take the good news to everywhere we go, in particular to Africa, to let people know how kind people are being to us, and to let them know how they are put the funds together, you know, to make sure we benefit from their hard work.
There's been about 10 really strong African use cases developed over the last few weeks. And what's really interesting is every one of them is a demonstration of how open science can really work in Africa for Africans. I'd like to thank all the people who participated, in particular the people who have taken time to come and enthusiastically train the students who have attended the ACFest across a range of really fascinating cutting-edge technologies. And of course, I'd like to thank the students for taking part. They've all been fantastic. They've all been incredibly enthusiastic, and we're looking forward to seeing how every one of these use cases make progress over the next few months.